The U.S. Army is purchasing hundreds of Coyote interceptors designed to neutralize drones from the defense contractor Raytheon, enhancing its capability to counter unmanned aerial systems. On February 9th, the military branch confirmed its commitment to acquire 600 ground-launched, radar-guided Coyote 2C devices for a sum of $75 million. The contract award was part of an Office of the Secretary of Defense Rapid Acquisition Authority that was identified to Congress with all actions completed in less than 30 days from the authorization approval and receipt of funding. Viewers may note that this follows a request for information for the acquisition of around 7,000 Coyotes. The December solicitation was for 6,000 kinetic Coyotes, 700 non-kinetic Coyotes, 252 fixed launchers, 52 mobile launchers, 118 fixed KU band radars, and 33 mobile radars. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the U.S. Army is acquiring 600 Coyote 2C on an urgent basis. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The move comes only 2 months after a Department of Defense official raised the urgency of acquiring anti-drone technology. In December, Under Secretary of Defense for Acquisition and Sustainment William LaPlante, citing the heavy use of drones in Ukraine, said that the United States needed to increase its counter-drone capabilities quickly, saying the military needs it at scale. "It's an urgent issue," LaPlante said at a defense conference that month, mid-January, calling the situation a crisis. The Pentagon already has Coyote munitions, but this new deal will expand the U.S. Army's arsenal fast. This allows the U.S. Army to much more quickly acquire and field the munitions compared to the normal process, which can take months, if not longer. The contract was made in mid-January, with the U.S. Army only announcing it this week. The U.S. Army said in a release, "The contract supports a Coyote interceptor demand increase and subsequent need to increase production capacity. The Coyote is a key component of the counter-UAS system of systems. It's a ground-launched, radar-guided interceptor with kinetic and non-kinetic variants that integrates into fixed-site low, slow, small unmanned aircraft system, integrated defeat systems, and mobile slow, small unmanned aircraft system, integrated defeat systems." As per manufacturer Raytheon, Coyote Kinetic Effector is a low-cost rail-launched missile variant with a boost rocket motor and a turbine engine for high-speed counter-unmanned aircraft system missions. The complete system consists of mainly three components. 1. Four-tube launcher that can be installed in both mobile and stationary configuration. 2. Raytheon's own KU band radio frequency system, or KRFS. This fire control radar will cue Coyote to intercept their targets. 3. A generator to provide the necessary power. The KU-RFS system is compatible with both the kinetic and non-kinetic versions of the Coyote. In U.S. military terminology, kinetic typically denotes missiles or conventional weapons that directly impact their targets. On the other hand, non-kinetic systems, like electronic warfare tools or high-powered microwaves, employ alternative capabilities to disable enemy systems. The Coyote 2C serves as a kinetic interceptor meaning it physically collides with the incoming threat to neutralize it. In contrast, the Coyote 3 operates as a non-kinetic interceptor. Coyote weighs about 13 pounds, or 5.9 kilograms. It can be launched by firing like a traditional missile from a launch tube. So Coyote could be launched from air, sea, or land. Once it leaves the launcher, the drone deploys its 6-foot-wide main wing, rear stabilizer, and tail fins. The operator can now issue commands to control and direct it. The Ku-band radio frequency system is a 360-degree radar that senses incoming drones, rockets, artillery, and mortars. It can detect Class 1 UAS out to 10 miles, or 16 kilometers, and can even detect objects as small as a 9mm bullet. The Coyote 2C features improved sensors and a turbine engine to increase speed to 345 to 370 miles per hour, or 555 to 595 kilometers per hour. It has a range of 130 kilometers, or 80 miles, and endurance of about 2 hours, depending on the variant. The system can be set up within 30 minutes on a vehicle or in a fixed location. According to Raytheon, multiple Coyotes might be able to defeat drone swarms too. The company could load it with software that it developed as part of the U.S. Navy's low-cost UAV swarming technology effort, or LOCUST, which lets them operate as a group. Cheap drones are becoming the weapon of choice for many military forces because of their cost-effectiveness. In response to the rise in drone attacks on U.S. military bases in Iraq and Syria, along with Houthi assaults in the Red Sea, the U.S. Army has intensified its efforts to procure and deploy anti-drone defense systems. Given the economics and tendency for drones to be employed in swarm mode during attacks, the counter-drone defense systems must align with these characteristics. While weapons like FIM-92 Stinger can also be used to take out drones, the Coyote is more suitable for an anti-drone role. The weapon system is small enough that it can be deployed at smaller operating bases. The U.S. government notice stresses on this very fact, stating that the U.S. Army has a need to develop, produce, and maintain countermeasures against enemy-armed and intelligence-gathering UASs operating at various speeds and altitudes, which are targeting both U.S. and their allies' interests at home and abroad. With the acquisition, it remains to be seen how long the U.S. keeps its defensive posturing instead of attempting to put the attackers on the back foot.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.